What was it? Just a setting?
It's a me thing.
Settings. What are you going to do? Just some settings. So Austin Pilk, you guys know each other pretty well.
Yeah.
Yeah. We have a lot of similar interests, and I like to fire off text messages at him at weird times of the day of like things that I find.
You like watches?
Yeah, we both like watches.
You like
cars?
Like cars. Wallets, cars?
Watches and cars. And like this little gadget, like engineering, I would say, is something we have in common.
Anything with carbon fiber.
Carbon fiber boys.
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of wild. I don't know if I've done anything like where you had a friend whose sister was like our friend, and then you became like a whole new friend group while still maintaining your old friends.
Well, I have a, maybe some say a gift, some say a problem of just penetrating friend groups.
Yeah.
And then just making them kind of my own. I did the same thing with like my like a friend, well, the friend that introduced us, his older sister. Like all his college friends are like now just all my friends.
How do you do it?
Perseverance. Just being annoying pretty much. I don't know, like I,
well, you were in a summer house with us.
Yeah, that.
But like, you maintained that friendship for years, and you became friends with Pilky, who was not in the summer house.
Yeah,
yeah. I mean, you just like, I don't know. It's just like, I like making friends. You know, I like don't have many people I grew up with that I hang out with anymore. So it's either I'm a sociable person, it's kind of sink or swim. You know what I mean? I don't want to sit at home, so I'm not like bashful to be like, hey, let's fuck.
What would be a tip to someone who's like struggling to make friends? What would be your one piece of advice?
I mean, you gotta put yourself out there. I mean, I'm like a habitual extrovert. You know what I mean? I don't really have much introvertness in me, except like Sunday when like I'm hungover. But you know, you gotta put in a lot of work into it. It's like not easy. I hate to say, I sound like a loser, but it's like no, it's like such a hard I've lived. So like, I learned that I had to do it. Like when I moved to Seattle after college, which was basically on a whim. Like right, work just sent me there. Within 4 days, they're like, "You're gonna move to Seattle." And 4 days, I was in Seattle.
Wow.
And I didn't know a soul. And that was challenging. It took me like months to meet people. And then after that, I'm like, all right, I got to like make sure I keep people close because that was like a lonely couple months. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So like you didn't make many friends in Seattle.
I did. Right. So there's a thing called the Seattle Freeze, which is like a known thing to where it's like, and it's like that West Coast kind of culture of like people are super nice to you. And then like they don't really fuck with you after that. You know what I mean? We're like, they say, oh, here, people will be a dick to your face and then, but like, help you out. You know what I mean?
Or if someone on the East Coast is really nice to you, like, it's like, oh, wow, this will probably be a real friendship.
For
while
sure.
Out there, it's like you just meet someone and they're super friendly. Yo, we got to fucking hang out. But it's like, no.
You know, yeah, you know, like, I remember.
Just the way they are.
I went out with like this. I met this like group of kids at the bar, which is weird. Like, trying to go like talk to like dudes at the bar, kind of. You know what I mean? And like we hung out one night after that and then just like never, which is probably my own fault too. I got fucking hammered, but like you just like never saw him again.
Yeah.
I feel like it's tough to make friends with like when you have no warm introduction.
Yeah, it definitely is.
Yeah. Especially now. Like
yeah, because
some guy came up to you, you'd be like, what the fuck?
Wait, what are you doing?
Yeah. I have this, there's this dude in my gym who literally, he's this new guy. He's from Germany and he is friends with, no one's friends with each other there. And he's friends with everyone now.
Yeah.
Like he just met me by like, I would just see him at the corner of my eye. He'd be like waving at me. And I'm like, what the fuck? I'm like, do I know this guy? So one day he's like, hi, I'm Max. I'm like, have we met? Cause like, he's like waving me down. Like we know each other. But he's just like, that's just what he's able to just talk to everybody. It's wild.
Well,
he's a funny guy.
Does it go past that? Like, does he hang out with people?
Outside the gym, like I don't know.
But there's also,
I agree. It's that's definitely a hard thing to pat.
There's
to do.
Gym guys though that are just like that's their social. Like every gym has that guy.
Sure,
you know what I mean?
For sure. No, that's him.
Like
sure.
I'm not that guy at the
hilarious.
Gym at all.
No, I'm head down. I would say he's a big dude.
He's got always if he's always.
Yeah, well,
gym.
That's where all your friends hang out. You got to be jacked.
Yeah, yeah.
All the time.
He has like a notebook. Like,
I think too. It's like you think it's gonna be weird. You know what I mean? But like if you like. Two people that are like sociable people typically can like just have a conversation.
Yeah.
And like if you're a normal person, like I think normal attracts.
Girls can do it way easier, I think. They make friends on the fly.
For sure. Maybe. I mean, I don't know, I've ever like analyzed the like other like women doing it, but like you're probably not wrong.
Yeah. I mean, it could, you know, it could be wrong, but yeah, I think, no, I think from my experience, girls can just,
I think they're warmer to each other.
Yeah.
From the start.
Yeah.
Or maybe girls have that Cali, what do you call it? West Side Freeze or whatever.
Seattle Freeze.
Seattle Freeze, where it's like on the surface, like, oh my God, I love your fucking coat. And like they like them, but like, then, you know, you go your separate ways.
For sure.
While like dudes, it's mostly like, oh, what's up, bro?
Yeah. Well, it's like you go,
nice meet you, bro. Yeah. For sure. It's literally what we do. Yo, it was nice meet you, bro. Yeah.
Yeah. I think, too, a lot of guys, like the random dude comes up to him, guy's like, dude, why is this guy trying to fuck me? You know what I mean?
Like, yeah. If you can't, if you're like, dude, you can't be like overly friendly to another dude for no reason. Cause it's just like, what's the deal?
Yeah.
Dude, and you know what
you get nervous. Like. They get nervous. Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah, but yeah, it's like, and I hate to compare it to like work, but it's like sales, too. You're just like, kind of selling yourself
yourself.
Random stranger, you know what I mean? But like I said, I like know I'm an introvert. I know I like to be around people, so
extrovert,
yes, yeah. Thank you. So it's like if I'm somewhere new and I like am gonna be there by myself, like I gotta figure out, like I need some soldiers on my team, you know what I mean, on my side.
Oh, for sure, because I've thought about leaving the city, and I just like I think of all these cities, like, oh, it'd be sick to live in the city, but it's like I don't know anybody.
Yeah, but that it's a smaller world than you think too, though.
Yeah. Maybe in like one little connection can turn into a nice connection, and then who the fuck knows?
Literally,
yeah.
That's why I'm sitting here right now. You know what I mean?
So actually, let me introduce you officially. Austin Gordon, I got to play a song. I always play a song.
First timer? Yeah, first timer.
First timer, bro.
First time. I said, this is the most consistent thing I have in my life is Steve doing his podcast.
Which is insane. I'm back on the horse, guys. I've been busy with work. I have a lot of guests.
Congrats on the new job.
Yeah, bro. So I got to start with a song. I'm going with, I had to go with the 1975.
Appreciate that.
I don't know if you know, but Austin went to.
I saw the Instagrams.
You went to three 1975 concerts in how long?
A week.
In 1 week?
Yeah, four this year.
Four, that's wild.
Three in a week.
Wow.
Yeah.
I don't know.
This is my favorite song. This is like one of my favorite songs by them, too.
It's called the 1975.
Yeah. Well, this is their intro. But
So I went on the set list and I was like, what did they use as an intro? Because that's what I always use as an intro. Yeah.
I've honestly never heard of this band.
Coming out. Yeah, they. So the reason I got into them, I have a friend from high school who's been a fan of them for a really long time, like over 10 years, and she saw them at like when they were playing at Terminal 5, stuff like that, like when they were really small. And I used to make fun of her and be like, these guys are fucking lame. And then she like posted a song on her story like 2 years ago, like during COVID. I'm like, let me try out these 1975 guys. And then like from that day, it's been like, I haven't gone a day without like listening to it.
What song was it?
Love It If We Made It.
Can we check it out?
Yeah.
Oh, you know, I heard it today, actually.
That's their like kind of controversial one. Awesome.
The song, I don't want to party, but.
No, but that song's sick too. That's somebody else.
So there's that rapper Mike the Stud has a song where he just uses that chorus. So I thought it was his song, but he just took it. I'm sure he credits them in the whatever, but I knew it as his song. So this is the song that made Austin love the 1975?
Yeah. Well, then you, like, you know, you nerd out, you go into, like, a deep dive.
I can see them on, like, an Apple commercial. But they're more prolific than that. They're not a one-hit wonder.
Yeah, well, this is, like, their, like, political kind of song.
What's it about?
So he wrote this for a year. He saved up tabloids of, like, just news, like, political news articles and stuff like that throughout the course of a year. And just kind of formulated that into a song. Like, if you listen to the lyrics, they're actually, like, pretty kind of intense. Like, good. Like, poppy, but they're great.
Yeah, I'm going to dip into them. Isn't he super tight with T-Swift?
No, they used to... That was, like, before, I guess, who she's seeing now, Travis, he was, like, the rebound from her old boyfriend. Oh. And everyone went crazy because he's a little spicy.
Yeah, what was controversial about him? I remember I saw some woman being like, I have to boycott the T-Swift show. Yeah.
I mean, this is the reason I like him, because he's just, like, always stirring the pot. And it's fun to be, like, kind of, I like sometimes rooting for the bad guy. Which
he looks like a badass Jonas brother.
Some say he looks like a cigarette. I've heard that before. And it's, like, that's a pretty accurate look, because he's just ripping. All he's doing is, like, just cranking butts on stage.
Cigarettes are cool.
Yeah, but they're English. Like, everyone from over there.
Do you know this band, Pilky?
No, never heard of them.
Never heard of them.
Nope.
But who's your guy? Bryce Vine?
Bryce Vine, baby.
Bryce Vine. I don't know.
Number
Bryce
Number one on Spotify.
Who's Bryce Vine?
It's Bryce Vinyl.
Okay. Like, oh.
Greatest artist ever.
What's the song? Wasting went away in California.
I think that is La La Land or
La La Land. Yeah.
I'd say like one of the things me and Pilk probably don't have in common is probably music.
I don't think I have it in common with music with you. With you, I think we have a lot of overlap. Well,
I don't like listen to music.
Yeah, see,
yes, you're a podcast guy.
Yeah.
But I drive so much, so like, and I do listen to a lot of podcasts, but like, I have to like mix it up. Sometimes I'm like, I can't, like, sometimes I'm in the car 3-4 hours a day. It's like, I can't just like listen to, I can only listen to so much Are You Garbage and like.
Yeah, you know, you need to cycle through.
Yeah.
Based on like the energy of where the ride's at.
Yeah, but my range is like completely. Like this, because like I grew up, my mother's a classically trained jazz pianist.
Oh wow!
So I grew up listening to a lot of like Luther Vandross and like just that type of
slow jams.
Yeah, and slow jams and just like a lot of R&B. So like that's where like that's like my favorite.
Do you consider Usher R&B?
Definitely, Usher's the best.
He's boy band R&B though.
No, I guess that like it can run parallel with that. So the 1975 is literally a boy band too, pretty much like a pop band. If you like were to kind of,
but they have a name. If they were, I guess the Backstreet Boys, but the Backstreet Boys like that.
Who would you compare 1975 to?
As like a band or,
like who's similar style and?
I don't know. Like I like a lot of like. Modern British rock, I would say, like alternative.
Killers?
Like, sort of, yeah. I'd say
more Killers than Coldplay by far.
Yeah, definitely. Like, I don't know if you know who like Sam Fender is. He's not like a big,
but
like,
yeah, dude. Sam he's Fender's, just like the fucking Killers. He yes, literally sounds like the
like
Killers.
Sam Fender's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, he's actually good.
I think they kind of sound sort of similar, but like they, that's why I like, I like people that kind of have their own sort of sound. So it's like,
yeah.
Who's the dude that T-Swift writes songs with? Canonova or some
no,
shit?
No, it's like something with a W, I think.
What band is he in?
I don't
know. Three Seconds to Mars or some shit?
I didn't know that guy existed until I saw a picture
Jack
with...
Antonoff.
Yeah. I didn't know that guy existed until I saw the picture of those three with Matty Healy at the club downtown. Like the social club on like Battery Park.
Oh, Casa Cipriani.
Yeah, Casa Cipriani, yeah.
I don't think I heard of him, yeah, until like his wedding in LBI and T-Swift.
Oh, yes, that was big.
Because I was like, who is this random
LBI,
guy?
LBI, yeah.
It has to...
took over the city.
It has to suck being like Taylor Swift right now.
Stop. Dude. She loves this shit.
I think that takes a toll no matter who you are. Like, that is like a level of... Which, first of all, she was always famous, but like, I feel like over the last year, she's ramped up
everywhere.
So hard.
She's about to be in a Marvel movie too.
Really?
So it's a conspiracy that
she's the most powerful person in the world.
Yeah,
in my opinion, like at least in like she probably has more political power than most politicians, right?
Her endorsement would mean a lot. If she was like, ladies, we fucking need to vote for blah 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 blah, she would get them to be like, you know what? Fuck yeah, we actually fucking do.
She just was like, Trump 2024. Like,
bro, if he got her, he'd win. No doubt.
Maybe.
I think whoever she endorses would probably win.
Yeah, I mean, because think of how many 20-year-olds don't vote, and or like, you know, that 18 to 25 range, which is like, I guess, probably her core fan base, or like 18 to 35 maybe, but like, how many people would just be like, all right, she said it, so we're just going to go do it.
Could a political party pay her $500 million for an endorsement?
Probably. I don't think there's anything wrong with it.
I don't know that side.
I think, though, if someone you like says vote for this person and you just do it, like you're a fucking idiot.
Yeah, well, I mean, every celebrity that has more than like one follower on Instagram, like is always just like vote for.
Yeah. Oh, for sure.
Yeah. Like Biden. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Do you think that's like buying votes? Is that why?
It's just like.
Like that hasn't been done already.
It's just like. True. It's going to be corrupt no matter what, but it's like. It's like, it's almost like you're lying. You know, here's the thing. If, say, I was Taylor Swift and they're like, here's $500 million. You have to say vote for Biden. If I was already going to vote for him, I'd be like, oh, fuck yeah. But if I wasn't going to vote for him,
it'd swing you.
She doesn't need the money, though.
She doesn't need the money, though.
Like, she hit a billion. I read an article this year. She like hit a billionaire status.
Yeah, or like she was on pace.
She's young. She's like our age. I mean, your guys' age.
She probably makes like $10 million a night.
I don't think it's 10, but I think it's over a million.
I think it's a lot, yeah.
But the movie's probably made bank.
I think it's like 4, yeah.
But she got people in the seats.
Yeah, she gave, and shout out truck drivers, she gave every truck driver on her tour a $100,000 bonus.
That's cool. Beast.
There's 54 truck drivers.
You go, girl.
Which is cool.
I know, that is a good move by her.
My people.
Did you buy the conspiracy that, like, she was... Well, no, it's so... I think it's been debunked now. But remember when people were like, she's going to the Jets game, so that if you Google Taylor Swift Jets...
I thought that was amazing.
It's not like her private jet... So her private jet usage doesn't pop up on Google. You know what I mean? SEO.
Yeah, well,
it turns out she's actually dating the dude, so...
I mean, but she's always flying in a Teterboro. I mean, she spends most of her time in her Tribeca place, I think.
Oh, yeah. I've seen it. So, I've been outside.
Teterboro is the most, like... the busiest private airport in the country.
Yeah. And she was like the number one user of private jets.
Yeah. She has two.
Hey, fuck it. She also helps economies. I'm not going to shit on celebrities for the private jet usage.
I'm not going to shit on anybody for the private jet.
Yeah. Usage. I mean, she also can't fly commercial.
No.
Imagine her sitting like a middle seat.
Walking through at Terminal C in Newark Airport waiting for a United flight.
Yeah, no like, fucking way.
Kidding me? Yeah. She can't even go to a wedding without like the entire town shutting down.
Do you think Paul Rudd flies commercial?
Probably first class sometimes.
I think he could.
Yeah.
It depends where they're going. Cause like, so if you want to go to Florida, right? Jets are something I kind of like learning about. Like I like big egregious, just reading about like big egregious things. Shout out the aerospace subreddit. But it's all done by hour. Like every like jets are done or costed out per hour, right? So like she flies, I think she has two. Her main one's probably Gulfstream, whatever, but like probably $22,000 an hour to run. So like, but take that and you know, that's like a 16 seater, probably an 18 seater. But like if you want to fly to Florida and like something comfortable, right? You're in like a 9-seater or a 12-seater, that's still like $16,000, you know, times that by 3. Getting somewhere, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
$12,000 times 3 getting somewhere. It's like, it's not always $1,000 to get like most places on a first class ticket, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I don't think a lot of celebrities can afford to fly private.
No, they can't, for sure.
Oh, yeah, no way.
It's so expensive.
They got to be, like, I'm sure if like a bunch of them are going on vacation together, perhaps.
Yeah, I could see that.
But like, yeah, if you're just going to like, say Joe Buck's going to the Super Bowl. Oh, Joe Buck probably, he works for a network, but like, say like, yeah, Paul Rudd. He's probably flying just first class to the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
He's not flying private.
That guy can walk, like, Bradley Cooper's walking around in New York City. Like, yeah, he's getting pictures, but, like, he can, like, still kind of, like,
yeah,
be a civilized person.
Yeah.
I just don't think, like, financially, like, their business managers probably, like, don't do this. Like, you can't, it's, you know, 30 grand a clip where everyone, you know, it's like 50 grand to get to LA. You're just going from Teterboro to Burbank or wherever you're flying into, like that's adds up very quickly.
Yeah.
If it's for business, maybe a lot of them do. If they're like flying somewhere to film a movie.
Because sure, like, the studio will pay for it probably.
Yeah. And like Taylor Swift, when she's like on tour, like.
That level, she's, I mean, that.
She could fly.
Bill is not worth it. At this point,
she probably is just no matter what.
Like, yeah, why wouldn't she? She will never fly commercial again.
Yeah.
ever again. Not I want to go on record. She will never fly commercial again. Here's me, I'll be in the back of the plane for a long time.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, out of principle.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck that.
It might be your own plane. But
get me a window seat in on a United flight right near the wing forever.
Yeah. Diet Coke and some crackers.
Yeah. Half a Xanax and a ginger ale. And I'm good.
Here's a question about celebrities. Do you think if two people were dating and one of them got famous, that they can last?
Like they're both just civilians?
They're both just civilians, then one person just blows up.
I don't even think you have to be a celebrity. I just think if one person gets rich, it usually doesn't last.
Yeah, wow, that's a good point.
You know?
That's a good point.
I think it really depends. Because like there are those stories where it's like LeBron is like married to his like high school girlfriend.
That is a very good example.
But
there's also a lot of rumors though that they have an open relationship.
Oh, yeah. You got to think LeBron is. You know, like, and that... You got to think he is.
I would 100% think so, I don't know the guy.
I don't know, but I think I've heard some things. There's probably NDAs being signed, but I don't think he's having like real relationships with anyone else. Like, you know what I mean? I don't think he's falling in love with anyone else.
I think he or she knows the deal when someone gets to that point.
He's,
you know, they're along for the ride, and I'm not, listen, love is, you know, it's great, but like they're along for the ride to have a great life.
Oh yeah, they're
on paper.
Their kids are, you know,
everything's taken care of. It's like I'm sure there's an arrangement going on.
And he can
on
still show her love without, yeah, you know, with while still having sex with other people.
Maybe it's good for the marriage, you know.
Yeah, but maybe, yeah.
Can we turn the 1975 off?
So what's good is it's on a different track. I just didn't want to kill the momentum, but okay. Yeah.
There's, I feel like there's also some aspect though. It's like if you become rich or famous and then meet people, like people only like you because you're rich and famous.
For sure.
Yeah.
Whereas like if you were dating someone before, that person just liked you for you.
Well, that's great. That is great, which is why you should stay in it.
But yeah,
like,
yeah.
But like then the other side is like I could.
Well, I mean, your life completely changes.
Your life completely changes.
Yeah.
For better or for worse.
Yeah.
For better and for worse,
yeah.
I would say.
Yeah, and I shouldn't say or yeah, and yeah. or for worse.
You know, you're never flying commercial again.
Depends on what level.
But people are acting differently around you. People are freaking out just because you are here. They don't know you and they think they know you.
I think like the fandom of like people like Taylor Swift getting like bombarded on the street, like somewhat has to do with her personality. Like she is just like, she doesn't put herself out there. Where like other celebrities, I feel like, are always interacting with fans and they don't get like swarmed.
I also think it's her fan base is younger girls, women, whatever you want to call it. Like
they're in love with her too.
Obsessed with them, but also like, you know, you get like Sylvester Stallone or like De Niro. Like these guys are massive, but like they're not getting swarmed like that whenever they go places. They're getting like, they'll, obviously they're getting people.
Hey, I'll take a picture with you. And they're like,
yeah.
Rocco.
I read a an article. I love I read the New York Post every day.
So do I.
I love tabloids, and Page Six, all that stuff.
I do Daily Mail.
Okay, I mean,
it's probably similar stories. Maybe they're juicy.
I should, I should mix that probably into my rotation.
A Colorado woman killed her 6 kids. Holy shit!
Yeah, that's exactly the type of article I'm looking to read. But like Marissa Tomei, who like I'm in love with, she had like I guess she's doing some Broadway play. And she was staying at the Chelsea Hotel, and like security had to be called there, and they were tasering people because like she was getting swarmed. But like she's a big act. She's an A-lister, but she's not like,
she's not. I don't even think she's A-list, but she's big time.
No, she's A-list.
Very respected.
I mean, she's got a Grammy. She's an A-list.
It depends what you consider A-list, but yeah, like I consider like Ben Affleck like A-list.
I mean, Ben Affleck and Marissa walk past each other, they're saying what's up. You know?
Oh, no doubt they're saying what's up. Yeah. Okay.
They're at the same.
That's
parties.
How you want to define it.
They're at the same parties.
Yeah. She's high level, but she's not like, you know, I wouldn't think she's tabloid.
I didn't think they're going to be tasering people outside her hotel.
Yeah.
You
I
know?
Would have thought that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because she's, I guess, you know, well, I guess when you get in that Marvel movie, because.
That's true.
I knew her for what? She's My Cousin Vinny.
My Cousin Vinny, yeah.
And The Wrestler, I knew her. That was kind of a comeback. Yeah, she's legit. Marissa Tomei. Wow, you're in love with her?
I think she's like one of my, like, I think she's.
What movie made you realize that? No, it was the taser story, actually.
I don't even know what she looks like.
She looks very realistic. You. Like, you could know her. She looks like she could have been a high school teacher.
She just looks wholesome. I don't know.
What is she in?
She's in... Have you seen the new Spider-Mans?
No.
She's also in... She was in My Cousin Vinny back in the day. And then she's in the movie The Wrestler with Mickey Rourke. But
she's in Spider-Man.
Yeah, but...
She's in Spider-Man.
She's good looking in that.
She's in The Lincoln Lawyer. Oh, Anger Management. That's what it's from. That's why. She's
Anger Management. Oh, I didn't know she was
Adam
in that.
Sandler's girlfriend or wife, whatever, in Anger Management.
The girl he's going for. Yeah, no, she's hot. How old do you think she is? 51?
Probably a little older.
Damn, bro. She's gonna. People are tasing outside at 51.
I feel like I've never seen her before.
She's a bigger actress than Kate Beckinsale. Kate Beckinsale fell off.
I couldn't pick out. And I'm sure if you should tell me this is Kate Beckinsale, I would. I couldn't pick her out of a crowd, though. I don't think
I could be fooled if there was 50 Kate Beckinsale lookalikes next to each other. Yeah. Like, hey, Steve, here's the name of the game. Pick out the real Kate Beckinsale. Yeah.
I would watch that show.
I will say though, like I was walking in Soho a couple years ago during like. It was during the workday, and there's this woman walking out, and like she just had this presence about her. I was like, "Who the hell is that?" And then, like 2 minutes later, paparazzi comes up, starts taking pictures, and then just scurry away. So I feel like just people that are like at that status just do have this presence about them that like you kind of just know.
I've heard that like these people have celebrity energy even before they're famous.
For sure,
that a lot of celebrities just have like a thing about them that like, which is almost what helps them propel.
Definitely.
So you know, they walk in a room, people are like, "Oh." You know, decision makers are like, oh, I like you for some reason. And then you have
movers and shakers.
Yeah, movers, you know, the fucking people. Yeah. P. Diddy. You hear about P. Diddy?
I just saw that today.
So
yeah,
apparently P. Diddy got accused of rape, like assault, and blowing up Kid Cudi's car. Did you hear that
part? I mean, P. Diddy's...
I've heard crazy wild. Things about
yeah,
him.
Yeah, me, yeah.
He seems like a sick fuck.
That's pretty gangster, blowing up cars, you know?
Yeah.
Was he like trying to kill him or just like sending a message?
I don't know, but I assume... I
think he's read the New York Sean Post. Puff Daddy Combs.
I assume it was a message, but if it was to kill him, that's fucking insane.
We had a long
time. Yeah, I doubt that.
We were on the way to the wedding, I guess that was 2 weekends ago now, and early, congratulations to you two, you know who you are. And
they're going to be listening? They might.
I mean, I'm going to send them, if you clip it, I'm going to send it to them.
Yeah, that's another view.
And they we were talking about how P. Diddy's in a lawsuit right now for Ciroc versus the distributor. He's suing them for... They are only targeting Ciroc to the African American communities. Like they're only like advertising it like 125th Street and above. And reason with the kid we were driving with, he was riding my car. He's like in law school right now, and he worked on the trial, or he was in the courtroom when it happened. Like when he won the emotion or with the motion or whatever.
Is he
it was.
Suing them because like that's ethically wrong, or because he told them not to do that?
No, he's suing them because he's like, I mean, ethically wrong, and he's like, we're not making as many sales because you're only targeting one group of people.
Ah.
It's like Clooney's all over every billboard on down Houston and Canal Street, and my stuff's only on 125th Street and up. Like there's a whole different market that we're missing, which is genius on his side because it's probably true.
But I wonder if they're like, oh, the reason we're marketing is here because that's who's buying it now.
Well.
Because, like, Clooney, like, what's it called again, his liquor?
Casamigos,
like, bro, that's premier shit around the nice areas.
For sure.
Like, Ciroc, I feel like drank in college for a little bit.
What do you
associate? Ciroc, boy!
What do you associate Ciroc with?
I literally just think about, like, a memory of my life of, like, in college, it was kind of like...
Peach Ciroc.
Ciroc was, like, the hot new thing. With that. And, like... But when I think Ciroc, I think of that rap song that says Ciroc Boys.
Yeah, because it's in the rap communities.
Yeah, that's what they rap about. P. Diddy.
They're not like, yo, Kettle P. Diddy's One.
And I think of P. Diddy, yeah, for sure. But I mean, think
Dice Pineapples by Rick Ross.
That's a sick song.
What's the last Sex time you all bought? Night,
a couple of shots of Ciroc.
Have you ever bought a bottle of Ciroc, like, recently?
No. No, I don't think I ever have.
Buy that. No.
But if someone brought it, I would be like, all right, fuck it. I don't think
it's whatever. I feel like it was the nice vodka we bought in college because it was still kind of affordable. Like, you could be like, yo, I got a bottle of Ciroc. Because, like, you aren't going to, I mean, I drink Kettle One.
Cool bottle.
Yeah, cool bottle. You could get flavors.
Yeah. Flavors are the shit back then.
And they had, like, the mini one that was still the shape of the Ciroc bottle. That yes. one you could, like, just literally put in your pocket. But yes. still be like, yeah, I got this piece of Ciroc. They just get, like, black.
Kettle One does not have flavors, I assume.
No, they do. They have a cucumber that people drink a lot. I don't drink. I don't
they really go like. Subtle because they can't go like fucking black cherry.
No, whipped cream Kettle One.
Pumpkin spice.
The first bottle of vodka I ever got caught with was black cherry Smirnoff.
Interesting.
My mom found it in my closet. I was like 16.
Damn, bro. Imagine like just
maybe even younger. I think I was even 14. I think I was probably 14. Well, I thought it was going to taste like black cherry, like Propel. You know, I was such an idiot. Burned. Dude, it was horrible. I didn't drink. I remember like having my buddy over and we're like, yo, we're going to drink this. And this kid who I went to high school, my brother was in school with, got me the bottle. I remember we met up at the Fuddruckers parking lot in the Ledgewood Mall.
Oh my gosh, Fuddruckers.
And I'm like, dude, we got like, we're going to drink all this. Like we're going to get hammered. And I remember taking one sip and just be like, like, and it's just never touching it ever again. It's disgusting.
Why do we always drink flavored vodkas?
Well, because we're child. Still the child in us that was like, we want this to taste good. Dude, I would mix, my pregame would be like a green apple vodka with like the Mountain Dew energy drink.
Oh, did you ever drink fucking Dude? Go
at like 8:30 p.m.
You ever drink like, Three Olives Dude?
No. Yes, tastes exactly like Mountain Dew.
Dude, we used to do, I've never had heartburn worse than that.
It was green too.
It was green. It was literally green.
Yeah, bro, college kids drink way too much. But it's fun. So, I mean... Do it at your own risk, obviously. But who am I?
We used to pregame my junior year of college. No, sophomore year of college. We used to pregame, like, four of us with a bottle, like, habitually with a bottle of Jose Cuervo. And we would, like, our tolerance was...
Jose Cuervo, tequila.
Tequila. Like, just, like, pretty bottom of the line. It's like what you get on a cruise ship.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah. It's trash. Well.
Yeah, it's totally trash.
Yeah.
It tastes horrible. And we would start with a whole bottle of Jose Cuervo. And then grab an
no chaser,
minimum limes, just limes. Like we would take like
we're not bitches.
13, 14 shots each before we even hit the town with it, and we'd each have our own personal 18 rack of Bush Light, and just get annihilated.
Like, yeah, you notice we don't do that anymore. We're not like walking out like college. You're like You were so fucked up.
She's so cool too. Hot and shit. Like, just walking to the bar, but
like already fucked up. Now it's like you don't even get there.
My college wasn't a bar scene though, or a frat scene. It was just house party.
So you're entering the party like,
oh yeah, like the fucking
yeah.
man.
Yeah, it's wild.
Would you have to bring your own beer to house parties?
Most of the time. I mean, or steal them from other people.
I feel like the few we had were like a mix or like the mansion where
the real house parties would charge $5 at the door usually or something.
We didn't do that at all. We didn't really have like, there wasn't like Greek life in our school. There wasn't.
We didn't have Greek life either.
Yeah, which I kind of prefer because everyone just kind of hung out with everybody. But it was choose your own friends. Yeah. Was, you know, choose your own friends and also like pick, like pull your own weight kind of. Like if you're going to come hang out, like you're more than welcome to come hang out. Just like, I'm not supplying you. Fucking.
Our school is basically like just like a big, basically there's the people who went out and the people who didn't go out, and there's like everyone could be there, and not everyone liked each other, but everyone could be there.
Yeah. How many people went to your school?
I think like
five and a half, maybe.
Yeah,
five?
Yeah, around there.
We're in like the same
4.7.
But you guys were like, were you, because I don't know, and you guys went in school in Baltimore, right?
Yeah.
Were you in like the city of Baltimore?
Technically,
like, we are in the middle of the woods, like without our college existing off the exit, off exit 25 on 93 North, nothing existed.
We weren't near like skyscrapers, but you know, we were a 15-minute drive away.
Yeah, we were like the from outskirts. Like a
city.
Still in Baltimore.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was like the address was Baltimore.
Like,
but
would
like,
you hit up your buddies like, oh, we're downtown? Or
We'd go downtown. Yeah. Every time.
It was probably like a 30-minute drive. Maybe a little less.
Probably less. 20-ish, yeah.
Were there Ubers back then?
I think Uber started to exist our
when we got back from abroad,
year, maybe junior
like.
Year.
Yeah.
That changed the game. It used to be us cab drivers, dude, and some were fucking ridiculous.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
I remember the first time taking Uber, it was like only black cars.
Yeah.
Which was wild.
I don't know about you, but mine still is.
Every now and then you'll get like a Mercedes just on the Uber X and you're like, oh, what? I got like a Sprinter van once as an Uber X. I'm like, all right, fuck it.
Nothing better than going from Hoboken to the city because if, you know, they got to get back, right? So it's cheap. It's just basically like the cover cost to get through the tunnel. It's always like a navigator or like an Escalade or a
good
Tahoe,
point.
And you're just like chilling in the back, like it's like $32.
Yeah. You want a water? Oh, that is nice. So Austin, like when I first had the idea to have a podcast, I thought I wrote you down as like a potential guest. It's because at the time you went from like your job in construction-esque adjacent.
Yeah, equipment rental, sales, heavy machinery, stuff like that.
You quit that to try to become a chef?
It wasn't like, I mean, it was a little quarter life crisis, I think. So
yeah.
I grew up in that kind of business, worked for another company for a long time, and it's all I've kind of done, all I knew, really. Didn't really give myself an even option, like, to do anything else. And then I was, like, 3 or 4 years into my career and was just like, let me kind of see if I want to try something else. Quit, went to culinary school, worked at a restaurant downtown that just shut down, unfortunately.
Coded?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Wasn't that a nice restaurant?
Yeah, it's 2 Michelin star. It's still to this day my favorite restaurant. I think it's the coolest restaurant concept.
Wow.
But they still kept like the space. They just, like the whole restaurant group's kind of just going to a different direction. I was just a dishwasher there, cleaning, or a polisher, quote unquote, is what my title was. Cleaning, which like, and this is a world that I didn't even know existed, right? Like I thought restaurants were just like, I'm just like a busboy, and you know, I didn't know like really fine dining and like the actual like operations behind a New York City premier restaurant. You know, I'm like, I was getting healthcare, I was getting 401, I wasn't making any money, but like, you know, it's like that is a career for. I mean,
oh, they
the
paid
whole,
you like a salary and they were.
No, hourly. I was hourly.
Oh, okay. Okay. Oh, you're saying you were getting the 401k.
I was still getting all that stuff. Like,
you still were. You still were.
All that. Because like, I was like, all right, I'm going to be on my own for a year, like whatever. But, like, I got a job at this restaurant. I'm like, yeah, here's your benefits package. Like, these, you know, after 30 days, these start, you know, these become active. Like, all this stuff. I was like, word. Like, this is something that, like, no
health insurance.
Why. Health insurance. Yeah. Great health insurance.
Yeah.
Really good and really cheap.
Really?
And they even kept it on when they shut down for COVID. They even kept the health insurance on for all the employees.
So you rode this job into COVID?
Yeah. I the last day the restaurant was open, I stopped. I was like, I'm going back to my... I was going back anyway. And I would like to hopefully get back into it after a certain amount of time. But I did it for like 10 months. It's great.
Wow. Yeah. You definitely... Yeah, that's...
Like, I got a taste of it. You know, like I said, I was just still like... I would go from culinary school 7 to 3. Then I'd work 3:30 till whenever closing time was at the restaurant, depending on the night, like 5 days a week.
How long did you graduate, or did you just go to the school?
I went to the school until COVID shut it down. And then I was onto the, there's like, it's four sections. So they kind of break it off into, I guess, you know, quarters. And the last quarter is like when you take everything you learn and put it together, and like, it's all like just testing and stuff like that. And I made it to that point, and then it shut down. And then I never went back because they gave me my money back.
Oh, really?
So I'm like, I could either go back and like under these like COVID restrictions, because I was already going back to work for my other job, or they're like, we'll give you X amount of dollars back. I'm like, I'm gonna take the money.
Oh, for sure. I was doing, I completely forgot. I was doing improv classes around that time, and they got shut down because COVID. And they're like, I think they gave me credits, and I'm not going back. But
yeah.
Wow. I honestly forgot I fucking did that.
I didn't know you did improv classes. That's awesome. Yeah.
It was, I did, there's like two classes. I mean, honestly, it was fun, but like,
But like you talk, okay, we talked about before, like making friends, like you got to do stuff like that.
For sure.
Like, that's a great place to start. What better place to start than a place where people are literally forced to be like.
To try talking. To make other people laugh.
Exactly.
Yeah. No, it definitely breaks the ice.
Yeah. Like all that stuff. Improv classes, intramural sports, like.
Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of how you have to do it.
Hollering at people on your stoop. Like,
you
however
can't just you fucking do. Walk up to someone and be like, oh, you look cool.
Yeah. Yo, I mean, where are you?
Yeah.
It usually, it's a tough vibe to give off. Like, if you just do that, you know,
it's tough.
You got to kind of be.
There needs to be a reason. Yeah. There needs to be a reason.
And like, there's always people looking to do stuff, though.
For sure. Co-ed sports, I feel like, is huge.
For sure. Also, that's how you can meet a chick.
For sure.
Yeah.
And then you can meet another couple there, and then you're going on double dates before you know it.
You're married with
you're
kids.
The fucking, you're the god. You're the godson of this fucking guy's kid.
Or the chick doesn't even have to be playing. You can meet a couple there, and she goes, hey, I know the perfect person for you.
Boom.
And then you start doing it that way, which has never happened to me. But
I've never played a rec sport in New York City.
I played volleyball.
Oh, I'm lying. Well, I played basketball, but like not co-ed.
I played co-ed volleyball on the West Side Highway.
Oh, I know of that league.
I love volleyball.
That's sand, right?
Yeah, sand. Sand volleyball. Yeah, it was awesome.
I think I remember you telling me you liked volleyball. I remember like, when I first met you. I was like, you play basketball? You're like, no, I fucking suck at basketball. I love volleyball.
It's so much fun to play.
It is fun as shit.
Yeah,
it is.
It's so much fun. And it's like.
Great concept for a game. It's like, hit it to the other fucking side.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's also good for intramurals.
Definitely.
Yes. Yeah. It's perfect. Good for, if there could be a girl who could be way better than me at volleyball, for sure. Without like necessarily being a college player.
Dude, there are chicks that were playing that. Played in college and would kick our asses.
It's like
volleyball.
Yeah, different level.
Yeah,
of course.
Different level.
Yeah, for sure.
I think that is a one, like, never mind. I'm going to stop there.
But like I played, so in college, I played practice with the women's basketball team because they needed players to scrimmage to make 10 full people. And like, these were Division I girls.
Still going and one.
Hot take, I think I was better than all of them besides maybe two. One of them was really fucking good. Like, she was like, she transferred from East Carolina, so it was a better school. She was fucking really good.
The women's national team lost to the U15 Texas team.
That you're talking about?
In soccer.
Yeah. I think it was U14.
U14. So yeah. It's like, there's, listen, by like, anyone with a brain like will five. Admit that there is a difference.
And, and they're the best in the world. Well, they were that team that lost.
What do you guys think about pickleball? Because I just heard that.
Hey, great sport.
There was like a top pickleball player, and Scotty Scheffler played him and just like kicked his ass.
Destroyed him.
Oh, the golfer Scotty Scheffler did.
Yeah.
Okay. No, okay. So I'm not surprised. Well, I would have picked probably the pickleball player, but I didn't know if Scotty Scheffler's experience with it. But it's
definitely
a sport
where, like,
I don't know. You don't need to be.
He's like a top three golfer in the world. But it's like, he doesn't look that athletic, but he probably obviously fucking is. He's tall.
I mean, John Daly.
Yeah, John Daly probably be sick of basketball. I bet. They're so coordinated. And
I get like, you are a professional athlete.
For sure.
So. John Daly would probably beat
golf,
those girls in
volleyball. Pickleball, I mean, I guess.
Pickleball,
it's
like,
too new to be a professional. Like, people haven't developed, I feel like, to like
exactly
really be a professional athlete in pickleball.
Yeah. Even like the best lacrosse player. Obviously, I think he would be the best lacrosse player today. Versus anybody, but like, there are other athletes that if they played lacrosse just as long,
for sure,
would smoke the shit out of them. It's just not a big enough sport.
Yeah, but I feel like that's kind of true for
anything.
For anything, yeah.
Yeah, there might not be another guy on the planet who would have been better than LeBron. There might not.
Michael Jordan.
No, but I'm saying at the same time. But you know what I mean.
That's like an anomaly, though.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I mean, one of
or like the new Wembanyama guy, like basketball might be like one of those sports. But yeah, football, like there could be a guy in the country. because basketball is worldwide, and so is soccer. But there could be a guy in another country who could have been a quarterback that has never seen a football.
But I bet you there's like a soccer player who's just like sick at basketball, and it's like,
for sure. Well, an athlete's an athlete.
Yeah.
And my brother swears by this. He goes, the only people that aren't athletes are hockey players. He goes, hockey players suck at every other sport. He goes, they could only play hockey.
And they think that they're the most athletic because there's ice skating involved. But it's like,
I had that argument as a hockey player myself,
I know I'm not the most athletic person usually in the room.
And also, like,
right now I'm the least, probably least.
The ice skating is like second language to them, so it's you can't take it out of the equation. Like,
I will skate circles around both of you, and because I still play men's league, I'm so out of shape. But like,
I can't.
I will skate circles around both of you. We go on a basketball court, and you won't eat, like, there could be me and someone else, or me and no one else. So like, we'll just rather have no one else. I'm so bad, but
and I can't ice skate. I'm sure I could learn. But.
Well, once you learn, you don't think of it. Like, exactly. That's just part of like the last thing you think about when you're playing ice hockey is ice skating. Like, it's
yeah,
just
left, right. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You're not.
But
you're just going.
Well, you do have to be like super coordinated and like have good balance.
I'm better at sports with like hockey and lacrosse. Like, I can pick up a lacrosse stick and have a catch 50 yards in between and be fine.
Yeah, for sure.
Lefty and righty. You know what I mean?
What about baseball, like, mitt?
I can't throw a football
you can't.
Very well. I can't throw a baseball very well.
Imagine like I put out one clip for this episode and it's just you saying it's like
new at least episode. I admit I'm not gonna sit here and tell you I'm great. Like, I know I'm not.
I think
it's
a great trait to you know,
I like playing catch. Like, I love playing catch with a baseball, you know.
So you could throw a baseball.
Yeah, I can't.
Easier to throw than a football for sure.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah. I would be surprised if I could, I mean, with zero control, pitch over 60 miles per hour, 65 miles per hour.
Dude, no, I bet. Yeah, I bet you can't. No way.
Yeah,
I don't think I can.
I think you could throw over 60.
60's,
so? Yeah.
60's not that slow for someone who's not throwing a baseball.
I think you both could throw over 60.
Feed the monster. Come down.
Where can we test that?
I bet Curly could.
Oh,
Curly, I bet Curly could.
Curly could throw like 85.
But he's because he's an actor. No, he can't throw 85, bro.
I bet you he could touch like 80.
No shot.
Pretty fast.
Can we? Should we call him?
Yeah.
Call Curly. Back to pickleball real quick, though. My friend went on a date last weekend, and he's like, we were having drinks the day before, and he was telling me the chick. He goes, yeah. She goes, she claims she's a pro pickleball player. I'm like, what?
How good could she be?
Well, it's also like pickleball. I mean, I remember playing pickleball in gym.
I think
class.
He's answering. I hope not. I don't know if he.
That's
is.
Like the last time I played.
Yeah.
Curly's like, probably sleeping. So he's waking up in like 2 hours.
He better wake his ass up. Oh, it's his one chance to get on the pod. No, it's not his one chance. You got one chance.
I bet you he would be like right around 80.
Fucking cocksucker.
Call Caroline.
I'm at the Rockette show.
Call his wife.
Okay, he's at the Rockette show. Oh. How can you throw?
Just say how fast can you throw a baseball?
How fast can you?
No control. Just like as hard as you can.
Don't give him any speed.
My brother's the kind of guy who thinks that if he had, like, if he played that sport, he'd be the best at it. Like, he played football, but he'd be like, yo, if I just played soccer. Or like, yo, I swear if I just played tennis from a young age. Like, he's a great athlete, but, like.
I think tennis would have been one of my better ones because I got the body. Oh, no, swimming probably. Should have swam. I'm a long dude.
Yeah.
That would have been my best bet. Swim.
I mean, I think you'd be good at tennis.
I have a tennis man's body.
All the pussiest sports you'd be fucking good at.
Hey.
Dude, if you're a good tennis player, that would be fucking sick.
Yeah.
What'd you say?
If you're a good tennis player.
That'd be awesome.
I think individual sports kind of suck.
Really?
I think it's a lot of pressure.
Definitely.
I feel like
pressure.
That's why it's good.
That's why wrestlers cry like, every
if
time
you
they
win.
Yeah, wrestling's, yeah. Yeah, fuck that.
You can't blame anyone else.
No, for sure.
Yeah, and I feel
they
like
they always
just like,
do, but.
So, yeah. Everything's on you. I mean, I'm sure a lot of, you know, players blame themselves for.
What are the individual sports?
You tennis, have golf,
tennis,
swimming.
Golf, swimming, wrestling.
Ice skating.
Okay, we'll put fighting and wrestling all in the same.
Wrestling's
thing.
Team sport. Because you're working, like.
What's well, so swimming?
Practice is you're going against somebody and you're all running together. Tennis
yeah, but you're
like,
all on a team no matter what. Like
tennis, you're probably at a clinic with other players.
Racing, right? That's all racing. That's typically.
Yeah. It's individual, although you're on teams, but it's individual. Yeah.
Skateboarding is in the Olympics. That's a sport now.
He says, right now? Yeah, motherfucker, right now. At the Rockette show? Yeah. No, just in this day and age.
I can't believe it's almost Christmas time already. I mean, Thanksgiving is next week.
Time flies.
What do you guys do for Thanksgiving?
Parents.
Same.
Must be nice.
I'm kind of pumped for it.
No one's in the no one's in the DPC here.
What's
I have parents.
But. I know your plans, but tell Pilky your Thanksgiving plans. He says high 70s, but I don't know. Laugh out loud.
So close 85, to 80.
Bro, 85 is legit as fuck.
I bet you he could bunny hop and throw 80.
Oh, you're saying from the outfield?
Yeah.
Do you think you could hit it? If he threw 80 and you were sitting around off the plate, you think you could hit
it? Like, I would need to see a few pitches, but I've hit faster than 80.
I would love to go to the batting cage. I'd like to go to like a sports complex like they used to have, like go-karts, batting cages, throw some mini
golf. Did you ever go to Fun and Games? No, what was it called?
Funplex?
Funplex. Go-karts and shit?
In Hanover.
We'd go there all the time. That was like a dope spot.
They have that. There's that like I guess they call it K1 or whatever racing in Jersey City. But like,
I haven't done those. I heard they're fun, dude.
I will remember this for the rest for forever. My dad and I were on our way to a hockey camp when I was younger, and like somewhere in like upstate New York, and we're in the boonies, and we see this billboard, and it just says go kart racing. We had time. We're like, all right, like we, you know, we're like, well, fuck it, let's go go kart racing. And we pulled up to this place. That's no longer there. And there was an indoor slick track. There was an outdoor rally track. There was an outdoor, like, regular track. And I was probably 13-ish. I had to buy a license because I was, like, too young to, like, have a driver's license. So they just made you buy a license. And I swear to God, we were going 85 miles per hour. I know it's, like, when you're younger, you're like, we got it in these go-karts. It was just us there. There was no one else. And we did all three tracks. And they went so fast.
That's wild.
It was the.
I wouldn't be surprised if they went like 60.
Not 85. No, it was not 85. It was like 60-65. Just like a baseball. Like, maybe not 85, but 60-65.
Yeah.
We were. And it wasn't just because, like, oh, you're young, you're flying. Like, we were flying.
I mean, when you're in like open air like that, it's going to feel like you're going nuts.
Yeah. And it was like the most bootleg place, too. Like, yeah, we were in like fire suits and stuff like that. We had helmets on. Like, it was the real deal, but it was just like.
Why'd you let him drive? He bought a license.
Well, you know how, like, there's like, you know, like the stereotypical, like, old bowling alley, like people just like drinking and smoking. Like, it was like that, but go kart racing.
Oh, I kind of want to go to this place.
If it was still there, I would just say, let's get in my car right now.
There's no way it survived COVID.
I don't think it survived like 2008, 2008, yeah, 9/11. It's definitely not there. I mean, I don't think it's there anymore.
Yeah.
Last time I went go-karting was 2 years ago in Colorado at an outdoor track.
The tracks, or is it dirt?
No, it was part of a racetrack. I was picking up my ex-girlfriend at the airport, and I'm like, I'm going to surprise you with something. What a great surprise.
Oh, wow.
What a
great surprise. Jet skis. Yeah.
So, like, I'm like, I got a place I'm going to take us. Like, boy, are you in for it when you land. Like, and I'm like, just like, you know, we're off the beaten path a little bit. We pull off the exit. She's like, where are we going? I'm like, trust me. We pull these go-karting places. She's like, I mean, I think she had a good time.
Yeah.
She could drive. So she was definitely, she ripped it. But
she's a good driver.
She's a great driver. Yeah.
Like, that's an attribute that stands out about her.
Yeah.
Like, what made you learn that?
She beat him in go-karting.
No. She could drive stick very well.
Interesting. Was that something that you guys connected on really early?
She liked cars.
Wow.
She was in cars, yeah.
Interesting. I didn't know she was a car girl.
Motorsports. Wow. Not like F1 and stuff like that, but like she knew like enough to be dangerous.
Foxwoods. Like, she has a Foxwoods hat. Not Foxwoods. Fox.
Fox News?
No, what's that? The logo is like a fox or like deer.
I think it's just Fox.
Fox?
Yeah. Fox Racing.
That's Fox
like
Racing.
That's like Ricky Carmichael. Ricky Carmichael. What a name. What a guy.
Wow. That guy was like my idol when I was little.
X Games used to be way sicker.
X Games was sick.
Now they're kind of like,
I haven't watched it.
I don't know who the skateboarders are.
Is that guy still the host? Sal, is it? Is it Sal? The guy he hosted X Games forever. The guy with the dreads.
TJ Lavin? No.
No, you know this guy. He's the X Games guy.
Oh, wow. He was a legend.
He's the X Games guy.
He had swag.
Yeah. Sway's. They look similar. They both have dreads.
No.
I think it's. What was the first name I said?
TJ?
No. What did I say before that?
TJ Daniels?
No. Look up OG X Games host, and it's going to be the guy I'm talking about.
Do you think it's still a big deal if you win the X Games?
It's probably more money involved now.
Salima Masakila.
Yeah, Sal, I think they called him.
Yeah, dude. This guy. Legend.
Let me say. Yeah. legit legend.
I mean, he's the first guy who pops up. I think he still is.
I mean, that's
a cool gig.
That's who owns the X Games? ESPN.
Probably Monster Energy.
I think ESPN does, yeah.
Energy drink companies just love extreme sports.
Yeah, what the fuck? Yeah, well, I wonder if they're going to sue. Like, you're only advertising the X Games. Yeah. What the fuck? You spend downtown Manhattan.
Yeah, why? How come we're only in the Rust Belt?
Energy drinks are...
You think, like, Monster's pissed, like, that there's not, like, a Monster in vodka?
I think...
Like, a Red Bull vodka is,
I hate Red Bull.
Everybody will fucking
drink I'm sure that like, there is a drink that has a Monster and a drink. And it has a prize and name, and they probably, although we don't know it, they're probably like, yeah, we have that.
Yeah.
We still have this.
Yo, we've never had a rum and monster.
A rum monster?
Yeah, rum monster. Yeah.
Can you look up if that's a thing?
I bet it's a thing somewhere not in America.
There's no way you go to a bar in Manhattan and they have Monster.
Maybe the X Games bar. You think there's a bar in Manhattan that gets packed for the X Games? Like, you know how, like, F1 bars are a thing now? Like, soccer bars will open up at 8 a.m. You think there's a bar in Manhattan that's like, dude, we're showing snowboarding at 6:30
definitely
tonight.
Not. But I bet back in the day when Tony Hawk was in his prime, maybe, but maybe not in the city, but definitely, like, the Jersey Shore, for sure.
You think?
A bar, though?
I mean, listen, X-Games I don't know about you. Kids. I think Tony Hawk's still in his prime. He's doing a podcast run right now.
X Games are for kids, I think. I think kids like it better. They're like, fuck yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great place for a divorced dad to take his son.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God.
This is what we're doing tonight.
You know what event I want to go to? Like, the X Games bar made me think of it. The darts competition.
I know a kid who went. I know a kid who went. I heard MSG.
It's sick.
Yeah, I think I've only dressed
MSG
as well.
MSG had it?
I think it may have been the lower, they have two theaters.
Or yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
I think it may have been the lower one.
I was at a sold out Madison Square Garden crowd the last two nights, and that is a lot of people to be watching a dart game.
Wow, I can't believe you went three times. By the third time, were you kind of like, I've had enough?
This morning, I was like, all right. But I think I'm going to go to London in February and see him again.
Wow. Maybe if I start to really like them, I'll come.
Dude, I think we should put a big, just for the weekend, like a long weekend, a Thursday to a Monday or something like that. You know, leave Thursday night.
I'll do it. Fuck it.
Play at the O2.
You're sick.
It's so much. Dude, any chance I get the crossover there, I'm going to go.
Yeah. Hey, maybe I'll go.
You should.
February. Nice, I got no plans.
So, another reason why, circle back to 1975. One of the reasons why I like them so much is because they have such a good live performance. I love live music. Most music I listen to is live, like live sets, live shows. Because, you know, when I'm cooking, I like to have something on the background.
Like, pretend there's a crowd, so you feel like you're with people.
Yes, that, because, my loneliness sets in. But, like, I'll have you guys over for dinner. Pilk's never come, but I'll have you guys over, and I'll cook for 6 hours.
You cooked me, like, a legit, like, crazy, like, it was, like, pork chops with, like, some fucking, nothing basic about any of
that was
shit.
A sous vide double cut pork chop. And then charred, served with a roasted carrot puree. We did
We
did a beaten regatta ravioli.
Wow. Yes, we did, bro. Wow. Good memory. This was like 2.5 years ago.
It was my birthday. It was my birthday dinner.
It was the summer?
No, it was in the winter.
No, I'm talking about summer, but there was a ravioli and there was a big ass pork chop. Remember when we like rode bikes for like fucking ever? Just me and you? And we saw like that couple breaking up. And the dude was like, I'm sorry. She's like, you can't fucking do that. Yeah. Everyone's like riding bikes by them. Yeah. And then we rode back and like, he's like.
Was it in Brooklyn or was it in Hoboken?
Hoboken. It was when I still lived there.
Yeah.
You cooked me a big ass pork chop.
Was there a lot of people there?
No, it was just me and you on a Sunday.
Oh, maybe I'm thinking of a different place then. Okay.
Yeah. But you.
Oh, that is. Okay.
But there's also some kind of ravioli in there.
I do another dish with pork chop. It's pork chop, apples, and you cook the pork chop in the pan. Go take the recipe real quick.
He's a legit cook. That's why. Oh, we know that. It's a culinary school.
Cook the pork chop. This is a great dish to serve at home. It's a very warm dish. It's perfect for this fall weather that's coming up right now. Get a nice piece of pork. Listen, the pig is undervalued in the American household, in my opinion. The
swine.
Well, everybody's so used to just like their dad cooking dry or mom cooking just shitty pork chops, like dipping them in ketchup with like Mott's applesauce, which no shout
out
to that.
I did Mott's applesauce.
Yeah, no. Listen, that's a great American meal right there. And, you know, Kraft mac and cheese. Or no, we did Velveeta mac and cheese with that.
Oh, Velveeta family, huh?
Velveeta family, yeah. But which is a classic dinner, right? In every suburb in America. I want to take it up a little bit. Get a nice, very succulent pork chop. Double cut, bone in preferably. A little nice loin cut. Season it, heavy salt, a little bit of pepper. Brown butter. So we'll put a bunch of butter, you know, put as much butter as you think needs to be in the pan and then probably double it.
You can't go too much butter.
No. Well,
Unless you're,
if you're really cooking,
if you're being ridiculous,
if you're eating out or you're really cooking at home, you're using a lot of fat. It's just how you're gonna, like, that's how things taste good, or how you, it's the base of making things taste a lot better. just throughout, I mean, in any restaurant you go to, you get served the dish. Think of the amount of oil they're putting into it and probably quadruple it.
Wow. Jeez.
But and they're probably not using as good of oil that you're gonna serve at home. Like, seed oil sucks. You should use avocado oil or just straight olive oil, which is what I use, or butter. But or if you even want to get, I render my own duck fat and keep it in my freezer.
Wow.
Yeah, which is awesome to use. But brown butter in a pan, salt, heavy salt on the pork chop, a little bit of pepper, bone in, obviously. Cook the pork chops while they're cooking. You know, it takes a little bit. Lower heat, right? Because you want to really create like a crust on it, and you want, there's no rush, right? Put on the 1975 live at MSG. Open a bottle of wine, do whatever you want to do. While you're doing that, take like 3 or 4 apples and then cut them, you know, core them, cut them pretty, you know, not just like
core them up.
Yeah, just bite, you know, just chop them up. Just core them up. Yeah, chop them up. Chop them up. When you flip the pork chops, give a little bit, add the apples in, let them get marrying and introduce themselves to the butter and the pork juices and everything that's floating in that pan. Once the pork chops are done, take them out, keep the apples in there, maybe add a little bit more butter, cook those down, sweat them up a little bit. You can add like some fennel if you want to, something like that, if you really want to spice it.
Say fentanyl?
Fennel. Fennel.
Crazy guy.
Yeah, and we like to party over here. But, and then finish it off with some maple syrup, drizzle maple syrup in it, mix it all around, really let them cook down, not until like, you don't want to like, you don't want them enough to where they're smashing. You want them to still have some texture to it, but you really want the, you know, it's like the sweetness in it, and then like you kind of got the savoriness from the pork chop that's all in there, and everything's kind of married and introduced. Sear some spinach, and then that's what I serve with it: seared spinach.
Did you cook this that intensely before culinary school? Because when I knew you prior to culinary school, you were definitely for sure chefing up shit.
And I was still cooking.
Didn't you like baking a lot?
I hate baking. Yeah, I love baking bread. I hate baking sweets. Because I don't eat a lot of sweets.
Because you eat them both.
No, I don't eat. That's the thing. I don't eat a lot of sweets. It's like the one thing I can have self control with.
If they're here, like one time, Chaz, our friend, was his cousin was selling Girl Scout cookies, so I bought like 8 boxes. I would just go through a box a day. I just throw them out.
Yeah,
I'm like, if they're here, I'm like literally just going to eat them all. So I threw them out.
There are boxes of like, there's been a box of oatmeal cream pies that my buddy bought 1.5 years ago that I haven't touched it since he's left my apartment.
Oh no, they'd be gone.
No, I don't.
I got like a bag of dark chocolate pretzels today. I ate them on the way
home. Chocolate pretzels.
It was 660 calories. Safe. And I just fucking downed it. 660 calories, I downed it all.
You know what my... I don't even want to say guilty pleasure, but they became my guilty pleasure once I realized how many calories were per pretzel. Snyder's sourdough pretzels.
Those are the hard ones.
With hummus, I take... which I have a sriracha plug. If you guys need it, I know where to find it. You can't find good sriracha anywhere right now. I have one store that has it.
Is it not just the brand with the clear bottle with the fucking
green
cap
top
on it?
Yeah, good luck trying to find it.
Really?
Yeah, there's a shortage.
Dude, oh.
Who makes that?
Sriracha. No, it's some name that I would butcher and not know how to pronounce.
I feel like that's the only one I can think of.
Well, everyone's buying all this fucking off.
Does it have like a rooster on it?
Yeah. Oh,
okay. It's a cool bottle. It's a very distinct bottle. They did a great job.
They make a great chili paste too. But no, you find it in the
the section that would have. Well, sriracha would be in the section now with ketchup, probably. No.
Well, I think
or tomato sauce.
No, it's still
hot sauce.
Well, all the off-brand stuff, because next thing you know, Sweet Baby Ray's is making sriracha. Everyone and their mother is making it. Heinz sriracha or sriracha ketchup. But there's a big shortage, so everyone
Heinz
else is trying
sriracha,
to capitalize
I will
on
not
it.
Eat, dude.
No, but Heinz ketchup.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, only it's ketchup.
One.
Only it's Numero the ketchup. It's
yeah.
the ketchup.
I would eat their mustard, don't get me wrong.
I am a big mustard guy.
I wouldn't buy it, but if it was at a barbecue, I wouldn't be like, oh fuck, it's Heinz.
Okay.
I'd be cool with it.
Yellow mustard or Grey Poupon?
I hate mustard.
It depends what for. Yeah.
Strike me as a mustard guy.
I hate it.
That's he's a picky eater.
My girlfriend put mustard in mac and cheese. Is that a thing?
Like
if she didn't tell you about it, would you, just,
mustard,
would you rather she just not tell you about it?
Actual mustard or like mustard seed and mustard powder?
I don't know. I wasn't there. I think it was actual mustard. I had a few bites and she told me and I just couldn't eat it.
Yeah. Well, so you know what?
I'm the same way.
Is it?
I like mustard, but like my dad like marinated a steak with mustard.
Yeah, that's the thing.
But like I ate it and it was great, but I just wish I didn't know.
So,
but it was great.
A lot. Like, I'm sure I've been to a restaurant and they've put mustard in something and I just loved it.
For sure.
So
it's a mental thing for me.
Beef, like meat and mustard pre-cooking go together very well. Like a lot of like barbecue restaurants and all, because you need to make the spices stick. If you don't want to use oil, you can use mustard. Like people put mustard on like smash burgers a lot of time are used with mustard because it cooks off pretty well and it cooks into the meat and you can't necessarily taste it.
Yeah.
So it's a good kind of base to put the, you know, the start adding seasonings and stuff like that too. A lot of brisket, a lot of people use mustard to kind of massage into it and then add the salt and pepper, which is the only way you should be cooking a brisket.
Do you like a chicken cutlet?
Fuck yeah.
Chicken cutlets are the shit.
Cold chicken cutlets dipped in ketchup the next day. I grew up in northern New Jersey. Of course I like chicken cutlets.
Yeah, they might be my favorite. Top three food for me. But I don't eat them top three. I never eat them because
they're a pain to make.
They're a pain to make. I agree.
Yeah. Yeah, but you walk in, like, I was not raised in an Italian household, but like you walk into like my, like, you know, my buddies that have more vowels in their last name than
Okalu.
Yeah. Just and you know, you just like smell their mother, like you just see her cooking the cutlets. There's just a stack this big next to it.
My mom made great chicken cutlets. She's Irish, but you know, I guess Brooklyn. Also, just being from Jersey, Italian cooking is Jersey cooking.
You're
basically
in the stratosphere of that, the atmosphere. Yeah. My mom never did. I'm sorry, you go.
No, I was going to say Italian food's basically like the food of New Jersey.
Yeah, Jersey's the home of red sauce joints.
Yeah.
That's
red sauce joints, you know it. And diners, but
diners are falling off.
Yeah, I feel like they're fading.
They're more of a vibe than actual good food.
Yeah, COVID really did a damage to the diner world.
Yeah,
especially in New York.
They'll have their comeback. Or like, even if the diners that exist right now go out of business, some fucking rich like Danny Meyer's been, I'm going to make a fucking diner. It's going to be like $80 burgers.
Yeah, right? Well, the thing about, you know, diners used to be so sacred in New York because you could go there anytime and get a meal at 3 in the morning. Now they close at 11. So it's like, if they're going to close at the same time as that other fucking restaurant, then why are you going to go to a diner?
You're right.
I used to go to Remedy Diner a lot.
I've been a Remedy Diner.
That was 24/7.
Yeah.
I was at the Bushwick Diner pretty late in the night. There's 2 a.m. But it was a shitty diner. Yeah. It was like a pizza place that was like, oh, we're a diner.
You can always tell the quality of the diner, in my opinion, by their onion rings. If they are serving onion rings that are gas, then the food's going to be good. But if they're serving the onion rings that are clearly just from, you know, as they scissor open the bag and they suck, then all the food's going to suck. Because I'm a Turkey Club guy. That's kind of what I get at diners.
Same.
Turkey Club with onion rings is my order. And then hopefully table pancakes no matter what time of day.
It's a vibe.
Yeah, for sure. And if the onion rings suck, all the food's going to suck, in my opinion.
Well, also, because if the onion rings are good, then if they're putting the time into onion rings, which is a very far down the menu thing, then you know, the fries are going to be fucking good because they're like, they're going to put time into that. Diner wings, dude. Why don't they fucking make them like other place makes wings? Like if you get buffalo wings from a diner, there is no sauce. It is just a fucking chicken wing that has a spicy feel to it.
I've seen them non-sauce. Dry, I've seen them dry with the sauce on the side, which is like the most offensive thing you can do.
Like where it's like, okay, if I'm going to have chicken wings with no sauce, don't make them like spicy infused.
Is it like a rub?
Not even a rub, dude. It's a piece
of shit. Some
of them
are just breaded and fried, and then they serve with a side of sauce, and it's disgusting. It's fine. I mean, listen, will I eat it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Did I eat it? For sure. But I remember this one. I also got an iced tea, and it was unsweetened. I never experienced it. As a kid, I was like, what in the world is this?
I'm an unsweetened iced tea guy.
Oh, now I am. Yeah. I don't drink sugary shit.
I don't either. Gatorade on a Sunday sometimes. A ginger ale is like my little treat if I'm really hungry.
If I'm on an airplane.
Best wings in New York, in my opinion. Blondie's on the Upper West Side.
Never been.
It's a great sports bar. Dive bar. And I'm not a really big sports guy. I just go for the wings. Great dive bar.
Blondie's,
yeah. It's on 79th.
What color are they?
I would say not golden brown because they definitely...
We're talking buffalo.
I'm talking buffalo wing. Yeah, I'm talking buffalo. I think you can probably get a couple other sauces.
Orange tint?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, darker than golden brown because they definitely keep them in the fryer a little longer.
Snyder's the bag with the buffalo wing flavored pretzels.
I'd say even almost similar to that.
So they're darker.
They're dark. Yes, 100% darker.
They're not the orange.
No,
prototypical.
No. Listen, they know what they're doing.
I like the orangish ones.
I don't hate on them. I like them too. But Blondie's, I'm telling you, go to Blondie's and get wings.
That's gonna be a TikTok. Best wings in New York City.
Yeah, for sure.
You're going to be everywhere, bro. And you're going to be like, I think I can make it back to the restaurant industry.
Good thing I don't have TikTok.
Oh, you'll be on it.
Do you feel like you judge restaurants differently having worked in one?
100%. But here's my thing when it comes to food. Like, and this is kind of everything in like my life. I don't do anything in moderation. I'm not a moderation guy at all. So like, I think that comes to dining too. And I sound like such a prick saying dining, but like, it's whatever. I hate like the stereotypical, just like run at the mill restaurant. And like I don't, like, I'm not going to go. And the food's fine. The food's
there
great.
Needs
like,
to be a reason to go almost.
You know, Hillstone or the Smith or like all those restaurants that are just like pretty generic. Like they're everywhere. The food's good, but like, you know, it's expensive. Like I'm never, you're not going to catch me at a place like that. I mean, I'll still go, but like, I'm not going to go out of my way to go to a place like that.
Yeah.
If I'm going to go to a really good restaurant or place that, or like, you know, place where like you're dining, you know what I mean? Or like, I want a dive bar. Like, I don't like the in-between. Like, I never want to live in a neighborhood.
What would you consider Anton's? Because I hear you gas up that place a lot.
I love Anton's. Shout out Anton's.
What brings you there?
The food's great.
Is that West Village?
The West Village. The vibe is really good.
What's the vibe like?
A lot of hot chicks.
Ah, because I overheard people talk about going there.
It's a good time. The food's great. Shout out Austin, the sommelier there. He's the man. The wine. I like drinking wine.
We should go.
Yeah, I've gone. I went twice last weekend. I went Friday and Saturday.
Yeah.
And I'm going on
Thanksgiving. And the 1975. You should go.
I've had a big couple weeks.
Yeah, 1975 and Anton's.
My last couple weeks, from the last 10 days, I went to the 1975. I went to the Comedy Mothership in Austin, Texas.
How was that?
Great. I saw Dave Attell at City Hall. Then I went to Anton's twice. And then I went to the 1975 twice.
What do you get at Anton's?
We mix it up. Typically we start with, they have this like, let's shout out pork again. They have this pate that's made.
shout out pork again.
It's made. It's a cooked pate. So it's like served cold. It's like just cooked ham. You guys would hate it. There's a lot of mustard in it.
You didn't need to tell us.
Well, it's served with mustard.
Okay. Well, if it's served with it, I'll eat it. But like, you know, I'd just rather not know.
Usually start off with that with some French bread, smeared all around a big slab of mustard. The chicory salad is off the chain. It's great. It's like the best salad in New York City is the Estella salad.
Where?
The endive salad at Estella is the best salad.
At Estella.
Yeah, it's the best salad in New York City.
Another TikTok.
In my opinion. But it's similar to that. It's got kind of, it's made it with chicories and a bunch of different, you know, kind of like different.
What's chicory?
Chicory is a lettuce. I think it's a lettuce. I mean, it's a root. Lettuce, I would say. I don't know like the science behind it. I don't really have much of a green thumb, but it's good. And it's got peanuts in it. It's got a really good, it's got blue cheese on it. It's just good. It's fucking awesome.
Yeah, I'm going to fuck with that.
Yeah, we get.
So Estella and Anton's, I got to go.
Yeah. We got the chicory salad. I love the angel hair Frances. Those hand-cut angel hair.
Ooh, chicken Frances is my shit. That the lemon one?
Yeah, it's the lemon
one. Oh, dude, a good Frances. So
it's hand-cut angel hair pasta with a Frances sauce and just breadcrumbs. Super light.
Chicken?
No chicken.
No chicken, just the sauce.
Just the sauce.
Yeah.
Super good. Handmade pasta. The bucatini. My friend Greg swears that the bucatini there is the best pasta dish in Manhattan.
Wow.
Which is a bold statement. It's very good. I don't know if it's my favorite.
What's your top
pasta dish?
Yeah,
he likes a limon.
I mean, I like limon. It's not number one.
No, I was just saying the other night.
The best pasta that I've ever had, I had at Co. Shout out James Lee. He served it to me. I went like 3 weeks ago, right before they shut down. It was a corn and miso tortellini, and it was awesome. Like the best.
What color of corn?
I think yellow.
Very yellow. I like a yellow
inside,
corn.
It was inside the pot.
Steve's big into the color.
Chipotle needs to fucking change their corn to yellow, but go back to yours.
It was inside the pasta, so I didn't see. You know, their tortellinis are pretty small. But
yeah.
It was served with Dungeness crab, too. It was I don't know, maybe not Dungeness crab, some type of crab. It was so good.
Not imitation.
Not imitation crab. No.
Damn.
Not imitation crab, which shout out imitation crab.
Yeah. It's a real fish. It's just they just make it taste like crab.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a paste.
Ugh. The word paste, bro. Tomato paste, I got to rebrand that shit. Call it something else.
I feel like it's worse when it's a fish.
Oh, no, there's nothing worse when it's a fish. But, like, tomato paste, I'm like, get the fuck out of here.
You know what also starts as a paste, pretty much, the at least consistency of? A McDonald's chicken nugget.
Oh, yeah, fuck that. Ew.
Which, when I heard Burger McDonald's King's chicken nuggets.
Burgers were, like, pink juice that got heated up and turned into that, I was like, never going back there again. And then we've had it since. We ate it once
together. That stuff doesn't, like, you know, I try not to eat, like, I don't eat fast food that much or anything like that, but, like, that doesn't bother me. Like, however they make it, has been proven to work.
Yeah. I will not eat Burger King.
You don't think you'll ever have Burger King again?
It's
like road trip food for me.
Yeah, but if we're doing a road trip food, there will be somewhere else where I would eat McDonald's, even though it's probably similar and just as
Burger King's pretty down on my...
It's pretty down on the list. I'd have Wendy's. Like, Wendy's, I'd get excited.
Wendy's is amazing. Spicy chicken sandwich.
If Wendy's and McDonald's are next to each other, I'm going to the Wendy's.
All right, well, picky eater over there. What's your Wendy's order? Wait, he said it. I'm just reiterating what he said.
But over there.
I have so many questions for you now. I want to know your Wendy's order, and I want to know your favorite dishes in New York. Restaurant and just like restaurant experience.
Wendy's order is probably just like, I'm getting chicken nuggets or just a plain hamburger.
No ketchup.
No, but ketchup.
Just bun and patty.
No cheese. That's all I need.
No cheese.
Interesting. No pickles, obviously.
No, fuck that.
Yeah.
The Baconator, just keep everything on it exactly the way it is.
Baconator?
I've never had one.
Do you like bacon?
Yeah, I love bacon.
Yeah.
What else is on that? I don't want
mayo,
like cheese.
Ketchup.
I don't like lettuce and tomatoes on my burger. I don't need it.
I like onion. I don't like when foods that are supposed to be served cold go into hot foods. Like lettuce on a burger gets kind of soggy.
Heated up too. I don't heat it up lettuce.
I love tomatoes. That's what I mean. It's like supposed to be served cold. Which I will say, I do like heated up lettuce. They're... has a dish to where
there's another one.
Cut out that name. I don't want people to know about this restaurant.
Take lettuce and heat it up.
It's the best kept secret. It's kind of getting more popular, but
is it like a Michelin star?
There's this, like I said, cut it out. It's this small,
I'm not cutting it out,
little restaurant in the Lower East Side. No reservation. It's the best French food in New York, in my opinion.
We almost went once, and then we went to that Tuesday's Kitchen, I think.
Yeah, Thursday. We don't want to talk about the Thursday Kitchen.
No. Oh, when I was late?
So fucking late.
I was like 40. But dude, whatever. My trains got fucking literally
stopped. Yeah, it wasn't
stopped. But
I'm not a big fan of French food.
I think there's a lot of it around here.
There's a lot of really bad French food around here, in my opinion.
I feel like it's a lot of like, well, when I go.
It's my favorite type, my favorite cuisine.
Have you been to Libertine?
Not yet. No, but here it's awesome.
I thought that place sucked.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting. Wait, back.
I just like any of that food. Like the menu was literally like monkfish.
Yeah, I love monkfish.
Duck.
What kind of chicken?
They didn't have chicken.
I'm surprised by that.
Duck or the mal? Yeah,
it was like monkfish, duck, some other fish. Like I didn't eat any of it.
I mean, I do want to say I trust your opinion of like we have similar interests. Watches.
Don't
cars.
Trust my opinion on food.
Food, we don't see eye to eye on. That's
What was that pasta you ate all the time? Cacio pepe.
Yeah, that's like
you made a mean cacio pepe.
Yeah. Oh yeah, you do. You've actually, I knew that about you. You do like cacio pepe.
But I can't. I suck at making it.
I don't love cacio pepe that much.
I'm not a creamy pasta guy.
I think it's the most overrated pasta dish.
I love it. It's like just fancy mac and cheese.
Where's your favorite place to get it?
That place, Fiasca Teria Pistayo. Have you ever heard of that place?
Oh, that's a
yeah,
mouthful.
I fucking just butchered that name. It's like a hidden gem. Nobody knows about it.
Yeah, when you can't pronounce it, no one knows. No one can even go.
And Isodi or Isodi.
I've heard of that place. Either. They just opened up a new one, too. They moved into a bigger spot.
It just, like, the problem with the West Village is it's impossible to get in anywhere. And you can't, like, go and put your name in and then go to a bar because they're all packed. So I was like, I just, like, don't eat there unless I just get lucky and get a reservation.
Yeah.
As a picky eater, what are your favorite restaurants in New York City? Say it's your birthday, your girlfriend's like, hey, you pick the restaurant.
I like a good steakhouse.
Hell yeah. Everybody likes a good steakhouse.
Keen's.
For sure.
Never been.
Keen's is great.
Awesome.
It's a vibe.
Awesome.
I really have only been to, like, Fort Charles. I don't really go to steakhouses here.
I've never been to Fort Charles. Can't get in.
Haven't I been with you?
It's so hard to get in. So hard to get in.
Have I been with you?
No, I've only been once. We sat outside in 20-degree weather.
Damn.
It was fucking miserable. The food was great, but it was miserable.
Yeah.
We should go to Keen's, like, or maybe around Christmas or something.
Yeah, Keen's is awesome. Great. Keen's is awesome. real old school.
Yeah, I don't really go to many restaurants. I got to find ones I like. I want to try Anton's.
Go to Anton's whenever you want.
Because
I will. The probability of me being there this weekend is so high.
Is it tough to get in?
Not when you're him, bro.
I've gone there enough now to where I can usually figure it out.
What does that mean?
Like,
everyone on the fucking floor.
No, like, I know the bartender, so if we're going to sit at the bar, I'll be like, hey, I got, you know, my buddy's coming, and then people will get up and they'll kind of, like...
He'll
take care of me at this point. That's why I like going. The hospitality there is great.
When you go to a nice place like that, do you want to sit at a table or you don't mind eating at the bar?
I love eating at the bar.
I feel like you don't get the experience. I guess if you're going for the food, you don't care.
I mean, what? But like, I'm going because it's a good atmosphere. Like, I don't. This is the thing.
Atmosphere is different than experience.
Yeah, this is my thing.
I don't need like an alien popping out. Like, what is your order?
My thing. What was that restaurant in Times Square?
Mars
2020. Yeah, Mars 2012 or something.
Headache
like that.
And
But
it was sick though.
It's so sick. But the thing about I'm gonna say the word dining again, like. The reason I liked the restaurant I worked at because it was such high quality everything, but I don't want someone hovering over me folding my napkin every single time I get up.
Yeah, but
I don't think that is good service. So that's like
give me a pitcher of water. Send the som around so we can talk some shit.
Keep an eye on me, like if I'm
But like I'd rather a restaurant to where like I can like just let me know when it's ready. I'll go get it. You know what I mean? I don't like to be waited on that. No. It's like, feels it's not privileged. Uncomfortable, but no, I don't, that's not that. I just like, I don't know. I like to go at my own pace. I like to do my own thing. Like where we're sitting there talking, like you're in a great conversation. And then it's just like, oh, well, we're going to put in some appetizers. It's like,
yeah,
I don't know. It's
yeah. But is it the same at the bar? Or are you thinking? I think
it's a little more eye contact made.
Yeah,
like, hey, buddy,
like,
you want something?
Yeah. Hey man. Like you can kind of just like, cause like, I'm never going to be like, to a server or to a wait, you know, a waiter or waitress, be like, hey, like fucking
a server makes their
here.
Way over to you, like so. Like they're already a man on the mission. They're like, they're not gonna walk to your table and turn around very often.
Well, and they're trying to turn tables over too. So if you're at a restaurant, especially on a busy Friday, Saturday night in the West Village or whatever, you know, yeah. You like realistically, you got like if it's a table of two, maybe 90 minutes tops.
Oh yeah,
for sure. They're trying to turn that shit. You know, an hour they want to turn you over because that's how they're making their money. So it's like the bar you can kind of post up.
Yeah.
And it's a nice spot.
Getting old fashioned.
I drink martinis.
Yeah, you do drink martinis. Kettle One Martini.
Kettle One Martini, Dirty and Overmuth. Okay. I drink Kettle One Martinis. That's I listen to the 1975. Wow. I get made fun of for not ordering. I hate gin. So like we go to dinner at around the corner. Bamonte's. Yeah. Like whenever we're all in town, like my buddy, you know, Nate, who.
Dude, I've been there with you.
Yeah, you've been there with us. Exactly. Yeah. You've been there with us.
I saw you get made fun of for not getting a gin martini.
Yeah, they gave me a heart because like they order our gin martinis and I'm the only one that gets a vodka one and they're like pussy, but I'm like I fucking hate gin. And James Bond drinks a vodka martini. I'm pretty sure
he's a fictional character.
Yeah, he wears Omegas and he drinks vodka martinis.
He is.
Isn't vodka not the traditional martini?
No, I think it is.
I think it is. Yeah.
Then fuck.
And a real martini doesn't have vermouth in it.
Yeah, put what are they gonna do? Put lead in their thing? Like the worse it is, the more manly the drink is.
I mean, I don't listen.
They're joking.
They can say whatever they want to me. I do not care. Yeah, but they could be like,
"Oh, bro, you brought it up on the podcast
of me drinking vodka." Yeah, martinis.
Bro. So clearly, it struck a chord with you.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know why it bothers them so much. It's just what I like. Like everywhere, like if I go to the bar and I'm ordering a cocktail, I don't like sugary drinks. I don't like. Like, I don't need to see a cocktail menu.
Gatorade on a Sunday.
Gatorade on a Sunday. but, like...
What's in a martini, though? It's literally just vodka and olive juice.
Or some people get it. Like, I get them very dry, which is no vermouth.
Some, I said there's vermouth.
Yeah, some people put vermouth in it. I don't like vermouth.
I thought dry was no olive juice.
No. Dry is no vermouth.
Dirty is extra olive juice.
Up with a twist is no olive juice. They usually do a lemon rind.
A back paddle flip daddy. So they add Coca-Cola.
So if I order a martini up with a twist, I'm getting just vodka in a fancy glass.
No, you're getting vodka, vermouth, and some lemon.
So if I get a dry martini up with a twist.
You're getting vodka and some lemon, yeah.
But it's just a lemon rind?
Like a shaking and ice. I think I'm not the best at cocktails.
How hard do you think it is to be a bartender?
Challenging. It depends where you're working.
Blue Haven. You're hustling.
You're on it.
You're also but it's a lot of serving beers.
Yeah,
you're on it. I'm not saying it's not tiring or you're not doing anything.
They're serving on a busy Sunday. They're serving thousands of beers.
And it's long hours. I'm not saying it's hard like that, but I'm in terms of like the craft of making the drinks is probably not
there,
that challenging.
I feel like
there.
People don't really give a fuck.
It's probably a lot of beers.
You take the Miller Lite and you're good.
Yeah. It's like, oh, this is strong. Fuck it. I'm not going to say anything.
Yeah, if you're like, if you're serving cocktails, I think it's really easy to get in the weeds because like someone orders a drink where you got to sit there and fucking muddle it and do all that stuff. It's like, that is frustrating and annoying, I think. But like if you watch like a bartender in like the zone doing things.
Oh, it's
like,
amazing.
Amazing too. And like the ratios are so perfect and it's just so exact. Like, I make a drink, I'm just like, fuck, I guess it's like, I'm like, all right, a little bit more of that. You know what I mean? Like it's to a T of just like the exact drop is going to fucking, you're good.
It's like chemistry.
For sure.
Yeah. I mean, as is cooking and baking.
Baking. That's why I don't like baking. It's so exact. If you're really good, you can adjust.
Yeah, cooking, like you said, you can just throw in whatever fucking amount of butter looks good.
You're going off taste.
Yeah.
Baking, you're going off like you need to have.
Lessons in Chemistry, that new show. It's about a chemist who becomes a famous TV baker.
Yeah, that's sick.
Because she's dope.
But I love baking bread, which is interesting because bread's so exact. But there's a lot of environmental factors with bread that you got to take into a play, like hydration and temperature and stuff like that.
Greenhouse gases.
A lot of greenhouse gases, yeah.
Sourdough is the shit.
Yeah, sourdough is amazing. I want to open up, my goal is to open up a sandwich shop, like a bakery sandwich shop.
Oof. You have a starter you use? Or
I did for a long time. I actually started a year ago. For Thanksgiving last year, but I was traveling a lot at the beginning of the year, or like in the summer, and I let it go. And I came home one day from a trip. I was gone for like 3 weeks, and I was like, I gotta throw this out.
Wow, what's a starter?
It's just flour and water that develops yeast, and it's like the natural fermentation.
Oh, it's like a kit.
No, you just get a jar, and you put, 50 grams of flour. There's like a different ratio to start it, I guess. Probably 1-to-1. We'll say 50 grams of flour, 50 grams. That's not a lot, but 50 grams of water. And then you just mix it up. And then over, keep it on your counter. And after a week, it should be like 7 days.
You have to leave it that long?
Yeah. Like
people leave it out for like years.
The fuck? The bread with the yeast?
No. So it's like you mix the flour and water.
You just leave it.
Yeah,
and then every time you make like a loaf, you use part of that.
Yeah, and then you feed the starter every day.
Flavors.
Oh.
So if you go to like probably a good bakery, they probably have a starter that's been in their family for like 100 years.
Yeah.
Just a fucking glob that they
take. I mean, no, if you're at a real bakery, they have like a massive kettle with it. And then so it's like you use, it's all ratios, right? So you're going to use like one loaf is like, I think typically like 420 grams of flour. A bakery, a micro bakery might be making 30 loaves, a macro bakery might be making 30,000. So it's like, it all depends on what scale you're doing. But take out the amount of yeast that you're using. Now, if you keep a starter in the fridge, you don't have to feed it as much. If you're keeping it on the counter and you're using it all the time, you got to feed it. Some people feed it every 12 hours.
It's like a human being, bro.
It's fucking weird.
It's a lot. It's like
alive.
Yeah. Like, dude, when I had it, I would like be laying in bed and be like, God, like
I'm hungry.
Not even that. I'd be like, because you don't want to ruin it, because typically as many days as you let it go is as many days as it takes to get back. And you let it go for a couple days and you feed it, it's gonna be fine. But like, it
sounds like a fucking plant.
Yes, a living thing. It's alive. I mean, you'll see it, like, dude.
Do you have one right now?
No, but you'll have a starter in a jar. That you're like, this thing is doing nothing. Then you wake up the next morning and it's like four times the size oozing out of the jar.
You could buy them from
You can get them
like
online.
Established.
I've never heard of them. Here's a segment we wanted to do.
Always have a name.
This is for the ladies out there trying to buy Christmas gifts for their fellas. What's an idea you guys have for them?
Good sourdough starter.
Yeah, so very unique customer base for that. very niche customer base that wants that, but Christmas gifts.
For a dude from his girlfriend.
Like, okay, what kind of item are we talking about? Is there just anything?
You've been dating for 2 years.
What's our budget?
Between 100 and 500.
A Seiko 5 Sport?
What's a Seiko 5 Sport?
It's a watch. It's like a watch. It's like just a great sport watch, dive watch from Seiko.
How much money is it?
You can get one
couple
for
hundred
like
bucks.
300 bucks.
Seiko what?
5 Sport.
I would say a good gift is...
Yeah, that's not a watch.
Like, if you got tickets to something.
Yeah,
like experiences. Concert or game or something.
You think?
I think experiences are always better than, unless it's a certain item that he really wants. But, like, I think doing something is always.
I think clothes are great.
Yeah, clothes are great. But
I think, because then, like.
But that's, like, so, it's, like, clothes. It's, like.
Yeah, but if they're good, then you wear them
like,
forever.
What, like, do you have a shirt or pants or something?
Yeah, that Diamondback
shirt. No, this I bought it by myself.
I mean, a good pair of jeans. But I like going out to get my clothes because, like, I learned.
I like doing both. I think the best advice I would give someone for buying gifts for someone is get someone something that they would want, but they don't want to fucking buy. Those are the best gifts. You're like, oh, sick. I wanted this, but, like, I was never going to really fucking go buy it.
It depends person to person, too. Like, you know, your girlfriend might get you Giants tickets and you're pumped. Someone gets me Giants tickets. I'm like, I mean, I'll be appreciative, but I'm like, fucking, let's sell these and do something else.
You
know what I mean?
Well,
like,
yeah,
it all depends on who the person is.
Yeah.
Generically speaking,
concert tickets over sports tickets, I think.
For sure. For me.
For a couple, I think, for sure. It's just more of a couple experience. A sports game is probably a lot of like, oh, yeah, he went to college here, blah, 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 blah. A lot of mansplaining going on at those. Yeah.
I got Bill Burr tickets once, which is pretty sweet.
Yeah, exactly. That's fun. And you'll never forget that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I got 1975 tickets, and it was awesome.
Yeah. It was great. How many times have you seen them live?
4.
Damn.
This year, I saw them 4 times.
Damn.
But that was my, someone gifted them to me for.
For myself.
No. it was great. It was perfect. It was a trip with a concert. It was awesome.
Where, was that in Texas?
In London.
You already saw them in London?
Yeah, in January.
Oh, and you're going back again?
I want to go next year, yeah. Well,
is he British? Right. Oh, I didn't know.
They're from Manchester. Right outside. Wow. All four. They've been a band for 20 years.
Really?
How old is that
exactly.
Guy?
People don't know this. They're 33, 34. They started when they were 12.
What the fuck?
In high school. They all went to school together and they started. They started and their name was Drive Like I Do, which.
That's kind of a cool name for sixth graders to come up with.
For sure. And they've just developed and now they are selling out all over the
world. That's the dream. There's got to be a movie about
that. 20 years they've been a band. People think that like they just came up one day and it's just like, oh, the 1975. It's like, no, they've been fucking ripping it for
that's
a long
time. That's the dream, making it with your best friends.
For sure.
Yeah.
That's what we're going to do, guys. Oh, that camera just went out. So let's wrap it up. Austin, what song do you think I'm going to play to wrap it up?
I don't know, but this was fun. This was great.
You were great. Yeah, bro. And Pilky, obviously, thanks for coming back.
Yeah, Pilky the man. We can travel back over to the island together.
Are you biking?
I can.
Yeah, whatever
Did
you want.
Did you bring a bike?
No, city bike.
Are we going to bike over the bridge?
Hell yeah.
I'll totally do that.
Yeah, it's fun.
It cost me $35. I could definitely do it.
The boys are biking.
City bike.
It's if you go from Brooklyn to Manhattan, it's capped.
No cap.
Like $4.
It's capped.
Woke up this morning, can't remember nothing to bitches, just flew in from London.
1975.
I love this song. See, this is my range
though.
I'm all over.
When I think of you, I think of this song. And now I think of 1975.
Listen, when you're getting ready to go out and you're with your buddies and you're drinking and like the juices are flowing, you throw this one on.
Oh yeah.
Raise the bar a little bit.
The juices keep flowing. Thanks for listening, guys. This was a fun one.
It was
hey,
great.
Thanks for coming. This is a late one too. It's 10:15. That's an hour past my bedtime. Thanks for listening, guys.
Peace.